So how do you keep the team from kind of unplugging as we head into the season? As customers maybe are also a little bit scattered with the holiday season, how do you tactically go, hey, team, we got to stay plugged in. We got to stay game on with our foot on the pedal.
That's a great question. Well, as you know, we only hire people here who are really plugged into our mission, who care about the needs of our customers. And I hope that's true for our audience as well, that nobody at their workplace just has a job for a paycheck. But our team members actually care deeply about our customers. And we talk about the fact that our customers, for a lot of them, the holidays are a difficult time. And we talk about that our customers are probably not going to be at their best. If they're having financial stress, there's no more stressful time than Christmas and Christmas shopping and all the things we want to do. And we talk about the fact that our customers may not be at their best. And so Ramsey Solutions needs to be at our very best so that we can help those people through a difficult time by extra service.
Yeah. And when it comes to unplugging, there's another side of the spectrum where it's hard for people to actually unplug. So instead of keeping their foot on the gas, they're like, I can't stop, man. How do I stop? I'm checking email at nights. I'm, you know, hanging out with my in-laws, but I'm still working. What are some of those ways that we help our team actually unplug in a healthy way?
Well, in addition to talking about it, in addition to talking about the importance of our customer, that's to keep the person who might want to slow down from slowing down too quickly. On the other end of the spectrum, as you described, we've got people who don't know how to slow down, don't know how to gear down in their work. And we're just as tough on those folks as we are on people who want to slow down too quickly, because we know if we don't take time away from our work to slow down, to celebrate with each other and away from each other, to get some quiet time, to be with our families, real quality time with our families, if we don't do that, it's just a matter of time before even the toughest of us are going to hit a wall. And we're going to have problems, our family's going to have problems. And so we're looking for that balance between our foot on the gas all the time, but then there comes that time to go, it's time to not just slow down, but actually stop. We take quite a bit of time away from the office here at Ramsey Solutions, and we don't want people sneaking on their laptops, pushing that project just a little bit further. We want those people to really put the devices away and have some quality, fun time with their family during the holidays.
Yeah, and while we don't stop here at Ramsey Solutions, there are some different rhythms that we have when it comes to, especially November and December. We like to party, so we like to do that. We really focus in on ministry time and take the focus off of what we're doing and really try to go serve the community. We have generous PTO. What are some of those examples of how Ramsey does that?
Well, last year we did some neat things where we helped some folks outside of Ramsey. We gave a lot of money away last year, and we paid off some debt for some people who couldn't pay it off for themselves, and we bought some bicycles for some kids who were in a children's home here locally, and we bought some Christmas presents for the people who are taking care of them, and we turned that focus away from ourselves and start going, let's start giving to other people. And when you take that focus off of yourself, that's just sort of a natural way to start telling yourself it's that time of year. Let's start reflecting on the year. Let's start reflecting on that this isn't all about me, that there are other people involved in this with me and on this journey. And it helps sort of prepare our minds for this time of year as we try to make sure that we're grateful for everything that's happened for the year, taking time to celebrate. That's something, if we're not careful at Ramsey Solutions, we're pretty competitive. We can win the Super Bowl, and if we're not careful, we'll be ready to get back to practice the next day. But we've done a good job of saying, let's stop and actually celebrate the wins and take some time and rest and heal so that when we come back to work, we're ready to get back to work.
Yeah, that's so important. And it is really one of my favorite times of the year here at Ramsey. Being here 8 years, I've experienced a lot of our epic Christmas parties, a lot of our incredible serving opportunities that kind of make you take a pause, slow down a little bit, slow down your rhythm, look back at what we've accomplished, look outward at the people that really who we're here for. And it really helps center yourself as you head into a new year. So I think for a lot of small business owners, they've been running and gunning so hard. And like you're saying, it's so easy just to go from December 31st to January 1st.
That's right.
And nothing really changed.
It's also worth mentioning that a portion of our audience, the holidays is their Super Bowl. Mm-hmm. If you're in event planning, or you're in retail, or you're in food service in a restaurant, the fourth quarter of the year is your Super Bowl. And so that group particularly, they may not be able to slow down as much as someone whose Super Bowl season is in the summer, but they need to still plan that rest time, that sabbatical time. They may have a slow time in the spring or the summer where they need to plan that time. So it doesn't have to be a certain day on the calendar, but it must be planned and put on your calendar, or else it is easy just to work right through it. And as we've learned, that just doesn't work for a long period of time.